Have you ever had something that you really want, but can't get? Type yes if this sounds familiar to you. Many of us fail to achieve our goals because we are not honest about our motives. We end up saying what we think we should want, and thus we get nothing from prayer, nothing from self-knowledge, and thus we cannot get out of the same old cycle of trying to satisfy our own needs. Therefore, we pray and ask for what we think we should ask of God, but in doing so, we neglect our true motives. We are not fully engaging our heart, our emotions, and our will. Jesus asked us the question, "What is your desire?" We might answer, okay, God, hallowed be your name, bless the missionaries. Missionaries? Is that what you really want? But you've been told to pray for that, haven't you? How about the Middle East? I pray for that too. Really? Is that the first thing you genuinely want to talk to God about? But let's face it. Life can get really tough, and our prayers can be shorter and more direct. Help us now before we do something we will regret. Tonation of anger, the God many of us grew up with may seem incapable of dealing with who we really are, but the God of the Bible came down from heaven to dwell among us. God does not take our weaknesses lightly. In fact, Scripture tells us that there is a high priest who cannot touch our struggles and pain. So you can come before God and confide it all to Him. God, I am tired. God, I am fed up. God, help me. God, I am trembling with anger right now. And if you don't tell God, it will go out somewhere else anyway. Better to confide in Jesus. This is why mere behavior modification programs cannot bring about lasting change in our lives. That's why we need grace as our default operating system. Jesus will look at you and ask, "What do you want?" He would ask. So you can pray about your weight. You can pray about bills. You can ask God why others seem so happy while you face hardship. The key is to understand that you are a child of God. You are a citizen of the kingdom of heaven. It is not what you have earned, what you have accomplished, but what you have received that matters. Remember, the person you talk to on the phone just calls you to vent or to ask you to do something, just to go on and on and on. You cannot speak a single word. It's all about the other person and nothing about you. When the other person finishes speaking, they abruptly hang up the phone and say, "Well, goodbye." Perhaps that is how God feels when we rant and rave at Him in prayer and leave Him without having a truthful conversation. Today, God wants us to learn how to speak with Him instead of speaking to Him. God wants us to know that He values communication and connection. As this video explains, God wants us to adopt a better attitude and modify the way you and I approach Him. Today's teaching is truly fascinating. After this short teaching, I invite you to join us for a prayer session. We all pray and seek God's blessings on our lives. These teachings and prayers will bring God's blessings into your life. Be sure to stay with us to the end to accept all the blessings from this video. Body, are there moments in your life when you know you need to pray but just can't bring yourself to do it? Are there times when your prayers are not answered and you have lost the desire to pray? It seems as if God does not have good intentions or does not care about you. What if you are guilty of the praying amiss that the Apostle James accused many of us Christians of? What if you are delaying the answer to your prayers because you are not giving God the opportunity to speak to you? Prayer is speaking to God and God speaking to you. But are you listening? Our prayers often fall into one of three ridiculous categories. Either we view God as some kind of empty gambling site where we throw in a small amount of money and hope to win big, or we are as stale and dry as an old dried-up bagel, or we repeat the same words over and over again. If any of these patterns apply to your prayers, trust me. And once you stop praying, your faith, hope, and belief will wither away like when a farmer stops watering his plants. James 4 verse 3 KJV, "Ye ask, and it is not granted you, ye ask, and it is not granted you." We have all heard about how important prayer is to growing our relationship with God. But there is something about talking to God that many Christians do not understand. We often hear of people who have had beautiful correspondence with God in prayer. Most often, they embark on a kind of brilliant soliloquy with God, calling Him by His correct name and speaking to Him in beautiful prose. Their words come out perfectly formed, as if they have learned a special language for relating to God. Those who pray pour out their hearts to God and speak to Him on a personal and sentimental level. Most of the time, we cringe a little whenever we hear such a story. Not because we don't believe the story happened as the speaker says it did. Undoubtedly, we believe the story completely. We ourselves have never had such a transformative and deeply moving experience with God. Many of us have not experienced that beautiful give-and-take kind of deep surrender in which God converses with us. This happens to us because we have not learned how to talk with God instead of talking with Him. Talking to God is very different from talking with God. Talking to God is like sitting God down and blurting out all the things He has not done for you. It's like complaining to God about all the pain and suffering you've gone through without giving God a chance to talk back. Talking with God, on the other hand, describes the conversational atmosphere necessary for perfect communication. By speaking with God, God speaks back. Remember, you are speaking with God. Deuteronomy 5 verse 24 KJV. And ye said, Behold, the Lord our God hath shewed unto us His glory and His greatness, and we have seen His glory and His greatness. God values relationships and conversation. God values relationships and conversations. And most of the time, when God answers us, we gain insight, revelation, and direction about possible solutions to our problems. While you are praying, keep in mind that prayer is a communication between you and God. Therefore, when you speak, you must allow God to speak back to you. Prayer to God is like asking for advice from a marriage counselor or a health counselor. When you talk to the counselor, both of you should sit comfortably and then begin to talk about all of your concerns, problems, and issues. When you are done talking, do you just get up and work out? No, you sit down calmly and let the counselor talk back to you. In the counselor's advice, you will get advice and solutions to solve or overcome your issues. In this way, God wants us to engage with Him. God wants us to sit back and listen to Him. We must wait for God to speak back to us. God wants us to trust and value His counsel. Proverbs 3 verses 5 to 6 KJV, Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and all thy ways shall be done. Acknowledge Him in all thy ways. Then shall the Lord guide thy way. One of the most common misconceptions about prayer is that it must be done in a certain way and according to a formula using correct religious language. However, the Bible presents a much less rigid picture of prayer. Moses argued with God about returning to Egypt, Exodus 3 verses 11 to 14. And when he asked God to show him His glory, God replied, I will show you my glory. Exodus 33 verses 17 to 19 KJV. And the Lord said unto Moses, I will also do this thing which thou hast spoken, and I will do it. And the Lord said, Please show me thy glory, that I may see thy glory. And he said, Let all my long-suffering pass before thee. Does it not seem as if this is a conversation between two people, each listening to the other? This is exactly how God wants to converse with us. Moses did not just say, Show me your glory, and leave it at that. He waited for God to speak to him. During God's reply, he got direction on where to go and waited for God to show up. Exodus 33 verses 21 to 23 KJV, And the Lord said, Behold, there is a place by me, and thou shalt stand upon a rock, while my glory passeth by, I will set thee in a cleft of the rock, while I pass by, I will cover thee with my hand, and I will take away my hand, and thou shalt I will take away my hand, and you will see the back of me. Moses would not have had his prayers answered if he had not waited for God to speak back to him. Perhaps he might have concluded that God does not answer prayers as we do. Another biblical character is David. David's prayers were completely conversational, asking God questions and getting answers. When we view prayer as relational rather than transactional, we can pass over changing circumstances and anchor ourselves in the unchanging character of God. Instead of trying to manipulate God with our prayers, we know that we don't have to fake it to get God's attention, just like talking to a close friend. And when we pray, Scripture supports and reminds us that God hears us, knows us, and wants us to talk to Him as we would talk to a good friend. Hebrews 4 verse 16 KJV: Let us therefore approach the throne of grace with boldness, that we may obtain mercy, and find grace to help in time of need. This verse teaches that we can come into the presence of God without fear. Don't get me wrong, it is important to approach God with respect and reverence for who He is. We must not forget that God is holy. But God does not want us to fear Him or feel unapproachable. When you and I consider ourselves close friends with God, we will spend time talking with Him, eager to follow all the instructions He gives us, and unafraid to ask for help in anything. Friendship is based on having regular time to share, open up, and be honest with one another. We can make it a habit to talk with God when we are getting ready, driving, shopping at the grocery store, walking the dog, cooking dinner, etc. God wants to be involved in every area of our lives. The more time and energy we invest in developing an intimate friendship with God, the more powerful and exciting our communication, or prayer life, will become. In conclusion, God does not want us to talk to Him, but with Him. He wants to establish the kind of mutual relationship that we have with our best friends, the kind of relationship where we can share anything. At all times and in all situations, He listens to us. So the next time you pray, try to think of God as your friend. This will help you relax, make it easier to pray, and remind you that God's opinion matters. Tell God what you really want from Him. Always patiently wait for God's response and be ready to receive it. Now, all of you who are within earshot of my voice, let us go to the Lord in prayer. I ask you to pray this prayer with me so that you may obtain all the blessings of this prayer. Let us pray to our gracious God, Almighty God, Heavenly Father, Comforter and Redeemer. Lord Jesus, thank you for this. I know that words will never be enough. Thank you for all the blessings you have given me, the wonderful people you have placed in my life, and the things you have given me to uplift and illuminate me. Lord, thank you for. I thank you for this time, this moment. Teach me to rely on you, whether times are good or bad. Lord, let me know that you are my God at all times and in all things. Lord Jesus, I know and thank you that you have created each of us without fear and with glory. Thank you that you have recognized our worth. Please help us to live as you intended us to live. Lord Jesus, help us to abide instead of striving and to live peacefully and joyfully as the heirs who have made me who I am. I love how you have enriched my life with people, situations, lessons, and care. Help me to walk in our ways for the rest of my life. Lord Jesus, help me to encourage others and be a beacon of hope to those who are hurting. Use me for your purposes and continue to strengthen my faith in your name. Lord, thank you for my righteousness, which comes only from you. Wrap me and my family in your favor, grace, and protection as a strong shield. Help me to walk in prayer. Father, I look forward to strengthening my connection with you. I desire a stronger and deeper fellowship with you. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Type comment, God bless me, to receive God's blessing for your family today. Share this video. Help us with this mission of bringing God's message to anyone who needs it.